This is Apollo Control at 30 hours into the mission. Apollo 11's distance from Earth is 105,853 nautical miles. Velocity 4,233 feet per second. Neil Armstrong conducted a conversation with Capcom Bruce McCandless on the O2 flow rate transducer. This is Apollo Control. We have a correction on those last distances and velocities. That distance and velocity is in reference to the moon instead of the Earth. To the moon, Apollo 11's distance from the moon is 105,729 nautical miles at the present time. Velocity in reference to the moon, 4,230 feet per second. Thank you.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. We'd like you to terminate charging on battery A at GET 30+15, over.
Okay, 30+15 for battery A, charge terminate.
Roger out.
This is Apollo Control. Apollo 11's distance from the Earth is 119,116 nautical miles. It's Earth-referenced inertial velocity, 4,679 feet per second. This is Apollo Control. Based on the present trajectory, Apollo 11 will enter the lunar sphere of influence at an elapsed time of 61 hours, 39 minutes, 58 seconds.
Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Go ahead, Houston.
Roger, if you're free for a minute, I've got some updates to the P-37 pads that we passed up to you yesterday afternoon, I guess. As a result of doing mid-course correction number two, the Delta V required in the TLI plus 35, 44, and 53 pads have changed slightly, over.
Roger, standing by to copy.
Okay, TLI plus 35 pad, the Delta VT should be 7992 instead of 8016. TLI plus 44, it should be 6112 instead of 6141. And TLI plus 53, it should be 8172 instead of 8209. Read back, over.
Roger, understand. 7992 6112-8172, over.
Roger, read back correct, out.
This is Apollo Control. Goldstone reports they're receiving TV from the spacecraft and are recording.
Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Goldstone reports they're receiving a TV picture coming down from you all. A little snowy, but a good TV picture, over.
Roger.
Ask them
if they can read the number.
Okay, stand by. Goldstone, this is Houston, Capcom, over.
Houston, Capcom, Goldstone, M&O, go ahead.
Roger, stand by a minute, Goldstone. 11, this is Houston. What numbers are you referring to, over?
Well, I guess if they can't see any numbers, it's kind of a lost
cause. Negative. Stand by. We wanted to know what numbers before we asked them.
Okay, I'm showing them a disk, and I'd like to know whether they can read what's showing on the disk, and also whether they can see PROG, VERB, and NOUN, over.
Roger, stand by a second. Goldstone, M&O, Houston, Capcom, over.
Capcom,
Goldstone,
go ahead.
Roger, did you copy the spacecraft request?
That's affirmative. I am
reading
the number on monitor here.
Okay, that's similar. Roger, that's both the numbers on the disk itself and the little words like program and verb, noun, computer activity, things of the sort.
Roger, I can read the numbers clearly. We can't distinguish what the words are because it is a little snowy.
Roger. Thank you.
Okay, I read verb, noun, and program.
Roger, do you see over in the left-hand corner, there's a big square one that says computer activity, comp activity.
Roger, I see a flash occasionally in that area.
Right, that's the one.
Okay, it looks like he's moved the camera at this time.
Roger. 11, this is Houston. Goldstone M&O reports that they can read the numbers on the disk. They can also read verb, noun, program, and see the comp activity light flashing. Over.
Very good, thank you.
And they also report you appear to have panned the camera over to another location now.
Yeah, we're gonna work on something else.
All right, just...
This is Apollo Control. We do not have lines called up between here and Goldstone at the present time, so we cannot receive the pictures in Houston. Goldstone is recording. The lines will be up for the scheduled TV pass approximately 6:30 this evening, Central Daylight Time. This is Apollo Control. The tape from this unscheduled TV pass will probably be fed from Goldstone to Houston following the regularly scheduled TV transmission this evening.
is called up.
Go ahead, 11.
Oh, sorry.
Are you? That's me. How are you there?
I'm fine.
How's
the old white team
today? The old white team's bright-eyed, bushy-tailed. We're ever alert down here.
Hey, you got any medic down there watching the heart rate?
I'm
trying to do some running
in
place down here, and I'm wondering if
they
could help me
when
they bring my heart rate up.
Well, they will spring into action here momentarily. Hello,
11. We see your heart beating.
Okay, well, I'd
like to see that site. Why don't you give us a TV picture of that one?
You got it.
Okay, it's coming in a ghost zone, Buzz. Guess Bruce said we don't have it here in the center. Houston, Mike, we see about a 96 heartbeat now.
Goldstone should be getting about the best picture of the Earth we can get right now,
John. Roger, Mike. Thank you, Mike.
We got a little distortion horizontal direction from banding on our monitor. I wonder if they're getting the same thing.
Stand by, Buzz.
I'll let you know. I guess it'd be more described as a waviness.
Goldstone MNO, Houston Capcom.
Goldstone MNO?
Okay, the crew is complaining of some horizontal banding on their monitor. Do y'all see that on the picture?
Stand by.
I don't see it right now.
Roger, he's checking on it. I'll see if they had it earlier. Stand by.
I guess when we're showing the Disky or when we're showing the Earth might be a better time.
Okay.
Houston Capcom, Goldstone.
Go ahead.
Okay, RTVD will confirm they see this horizontal bend.
Okay. Houston, the Goldstone TV people also see the banding when the same time y'all do, over.
Okay, would they call it a horizontal waviness, instead of banding, maybe?
I'm not talking to them directly. Stand by, Buzz. Let me see what they describe it.
Goldstone, Houston Capcom, could you put the TV down a little, please? Capcom, Goldstone, Roger.
Apollo 11, Houston, the Goldstone TV guys say that they have some horizontal banding across the upper part of the picture and across the lower part. They would consider the lines just straight, no waviness to them at all, over. Say again about the vertical lines, Buzz.
When there's a vertical line, these horizontal bands tend to put small waves in it.
Roger, I copy. He didn't mention that. Stand by, I'll check again. Houston, the Goldstone TV said that when you get a sharp vertical line on a picture where the horizontal banding goes across, it does appear to bend it slightly. It's the same as Apollo 10, they said. Looks okay to them, over.
Okay,
I understand. It's not our monitor. All right, yeah, I guess so. We'll have them look into it and see if they can suggest anything.
This is Apollo Control at 31 hours, 5 minutes. Here in Mission Control, we're changing shifts at this time. Flight Director Gene Kranz is replacing Flight Director Clifford Charlesworth, and our capsule communicator on this shift will be Charlie Duke.
Command interface with Goldstone, we'd like you to switch to Omni Delta, over.
Roger, going to Delta.
Roger.
Apollo 11 at this time is 121,158 nautical miles from Earth, traveling at a speed of 4,613 feet per second. We anticipate that the change of shift briefing will begin at about 4 p.m. Central Daylight Time.
Hello, Apollo 11 Houston, we'd like you to terminate the O2 purge if you have not done so already. And the TV camera people say that the lines are inherent in a camera buzz and it's something that we expected. Over.
Roger, understand about the camera. Say again about the O2 purge.
Roger, we can terminate the O2 purge at this time. Over.
Oh, okay. Fine, we'll do.
Houston. Please select Omni Bravo on board, over. Apollo 11 Houston, we're just about at the limits where we can get any kind of picture at all on the Omnis on the TV. The picture, I guess, would be just almost zero at this point.
Okay, well, for this TV program coming up in a couple of hours, you might get some thought to how you want us to stop PTC, if you do, for the best high gain angle, and also it'd be nice if you could stop us at such an attitude that we'd have the Earth out of one of our windows.
Roger, 11, we're thinking about that.
Okay.
Hello, Apollo 11, Houston. We got some PIPA biases and gyro drift updates for you. If you'd give us poo and accept, over.
Okay, Charlie,
stand by. Roger, 11. Okay, thank you much. Our biggest drift on the gyros is 0.03 degrees per hour with only X gyro on the PIPA's, the Y PIPA's the biggest, and it's 0.006 feet per second. So we're just trying to tweak it up. It's the biggest we have is about one sigma on both gyros and accelerometers.
Sounds good.
The system really looks good to us.
Glad to hear it, Charlie.
Eleven, Houston, you can go back to block. We got the load in.
Okay, Roger.
This is Apollo Control at 31 hours, 22 minutes. We're scheduled to begin the change of shift briefing shortly. During the briefing, we will record any conversations with the crew and play those back following the briefing. At 31 hours, 22 minutes, this is Apollo Control. Thank you. This is Apollo Control at 32 hours, 21 minutes. During the change of shift press conference, we had about 3 minutes of conversation with the crew. During that conversation, Buzz Aldrin reported on what appeared to be a weather disturbance off Cuba in the Caribbean. And we also had some descriptions from Aldrin on the view of Earth from the spacecraft's present position. We'll play that back for you now and then stand by for any further live conversation with the crew.
Well, you sure get a different perspective in this thing in zero-G. Right now, Neil's got his feet on the forward hatch, and he can, with his arms, reach all five windows. He can reach down into the LEB where the overboard drain is. He can practically reach everywhere in the cockpit.
Sound like Plastic Man to me.
I'm hiding under the left-hand couch trying to stay out of his way.
Hey, good idea, Mike.
Houston, Apollo 11, you got a cloud over the Houston area right now?
Roger, we just had a really big thunderstorm here about an hour ago. A couple of storms around the area, back over.
Yeah, I see one fairly large and isolated one. There are a couple more off to the west, but this one looks fairly good size. It could very well be the one that just passed over you.
Roger.
Yeah, it looks like the Cape's been having a little bit of rain, too.
Roger, the one we had here came in from the west and is moving east, is or nearly so, as far as I could tell.
Have views through this section, fantastic. I can see Alaska right up along the limb. And I'm running the crosshairs right now down the coast of California. West coast is Mexico, Yucatan Peninsula, up around the Gulf, Florida, Cuba, down Central America. And I'm running into the stop right now.
Roger, sounds like a pretty fantastic view.
Guys in the weather office at Patrick wanted to report on the top, but I guess all we can say is we're above them.
Roger, we'll pass it on to Metro. Houston, do you see any predominant weather systems as far as frontal type or any build-up of tropical storm type, over?
Not any large ones. There are a couple of smaller disturbances. Well, there's one maybe 300 miles north of Cuba, but it doesn't look cyclonic.
Roger. Oh, Apollo 11 Houston, we got a TV attitude for you and also an update to your CMC erasable load and your alternate and contingency checklist, if you could break that out too, over.
Roger, I'm not sure I caught all of that. Go ahead with what you have.
Roger, 11, if you'll break out your alternate and contingency checklist for the CSM, we got a update to some of the erasable loads on page
F2-20, over.
Okay, you're getting that out and you can give us the attitude for TV.
Roger, 11. Your TV attitude will be roll 261, pitch 090, yaw 000, high gain angles, pitch plus 28, yaw 271. That puts the left hand window pointed at the earth. We recommend exiting PTC with your updated procedure in the checklist, over.
Roger, I copy, roll 2161, pitch 090, 000, high gain, pitch plus 28, 271, and we'll exit with the procedure we have in the book, over.
That's affirmative.
Charlie, Apollo 11, I got a couple questions on stopping the PTC. It seems to me the easiest way to stop it would be, we're essentially, of course, at 0 degrees yaw and close enough to 90 degrees pitch. So it's just a question of stopping at 260 roll, roughly. And how about for a procedure going manual attitude 3 to rate command, and then thing is, now our dead band has already collapsed. I'll turn on the panel 8 RCS thrusters, at which time it should stop at whatever attitude it finds itself in. And if I do all that as it comes up on 261 degrees roll, we should stop right there. Is that sufficient?
That sounds pretty good. Stand by one.
Sounds like it might save a little gas. Apollo 11, what page do you want
that
revision, over?
Roger, 11, if you'll turn to page F2-20, over.
Okay, I have it.
Roger, 11. On under column A on page F2-20, line 5, line 05, the new data is 01042. Line 07, the new data is 00256. Skipping down to line 11, 00070. Line 12 is 00042. Line 13, or 7773. in column Bravo, lines 3, 4, and 5, which are blank, should be all zeros for line 3. Line 4 is 20017. Line 5, 20616. Over.
Roger, page, S-20, column, Alpha, 05, 01, 042, 07, 00256, 11, 11, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0,
00-042-13-77730. Column Bravo. 03-00-00-04-20-017. 05-20-616.
Right here, good read back. And stand by, Mike, on the coming out of the PTC recommendation, over.
Okay, fine.
Hello, Apollo 11, Houston with a recommendation on the exiting PTC, over.
Go ahead.
Roger, Mike. We'd like to see you go to Excel command on the manual attitude switches, then to turn on the auto RCS select switches, and then go rate command. That will prevent us from firing jets uncoupled, over.
Okay, fine, and I would guess go rate command and roll first and then followed by pitching you off.
Okay, that sounds good. And when you get to the roll attitude desired, just go rate command at that time, and it'll stop us right on.
Yeah, I agree, Charlie, that sounds fine.
Roger. Thank you.
This is Apollo Control at 32 hours, 39 minutes. This is a relatively quiet period in the flight plan. The crew will be getting the spacecraft set up for the passive thermal control termination and the television transmission. Capcom Charlie Duke has just put in a call. We'll pick that up.
Playing with the P-37 a while ago, and we collapsed the deadband back down. The DAP assumed that the deadband was centered around the new attitude that we happened to be at that time. Since then, we've drifted out a couple of degrees in both pitch and yaw from that attitude, such that if we did the procedure as we call it up to you, of going Excel command, turning on all of the auto RCS select switches, and then rate command, it would attempt to fly back to the pitch and yaw attitudes that it had when the deadband collapsed. We can prevent that by just immediately prior to going to rate command on the manual attitude switches, if you cycle the spacecraft control switch to SCS, then back to CMC. Over.
Sounds like a winner.
Okay.
Not gonna let these LEM guys play with my disky anymore.
It sounds like you better protect it. It looks like just about anything that you do with that disky is gonna collapse that deadband back down.
Understand.
We got a constant overcast here in the room. We'll see if you're right there. Stand by.
Of course, a little cloud from up here probably covers 8 or 10 states.
Now, 11 Houston, some of our guys just came in from outside and said it's pretty clear over the center here. It's cleared up completely. All the storms have moved on.
Okay, good.
Yeah, Charlie, I can see you through the section now, and I see the coastline is clear. Those clouds are just inland a few miles.
Okay, we copy.
Southeast part of the country is all docked in. California looks nice. The San Joaquin Valley shows up as a real dark spot with lighter brown on either side of it. You can't tell it. It's green. It looks just sort of dark gray or maybe even real dark blue.
How's the Mojave look? Is it clear?
Yeah, as usual.
Right.
It looks like there are some clouds just to the west of the Sierras, northeast of Bakersfield a little bit, then crossing over into the Mojave from Bakersfield looks clear, and then as you get on further to the southeast of there, there's a few clouds.
Roger, 11. Can you pick out Edwards in the sextant? Over.
I see a 104 taxiing out for takeoff on the runway.
That man is super.
Pretty safe bet. There's almost always a 104 taxi down the Tigo.
Houston, could you pick out anything around Edwards, a dry lake or anything? Over.
Negative, Charlie. I don't have that resolution. But to give you some idea, I can, in the lower Texas coast, I can see, knowing what I'm looking for, I can see Padre Island. I can just barely make out the fact that there's a thin spit of land, and then there's a little dark zone, which is the Laguna Madre between it and the mainland.
Roger, Lim, that's pretty significant. Thank you much, Mike.
Right.
Mike Collins is sending us this description from about 126,000 miles from Earth.
How are we, Charlie?
Stand by, I'll give it to you exactly. It looks like around 130,000, but stand by.
Okay.
Houston, the exact range is 125,200 miles, and you're traveling 4,486 feet per second.
Pretty far and pretty slow, just past halfway. Hey Charlie, what's the latest dot time?
Luna 15.
Say again, Buzz, over.
Roger, what's the latest on Luna 15?
Stand by, I'll get the straight story for you. Thank you.